Hey VC, how's it going? Right, okay. Another Stevie Wonder related video, albeit this time not cover versions. This time I've got three tunes that he wrote for other artists, and really this is just an excuse for me to play this song. This is Bad Weather by The Supremes. So this came out in 1973, obviously on Tamla Motown here in the UK. So I think it's fair to say that by 1973, The Supremes' best days were behind them. Diana Ross had left the group, as had Florence Ballard. Even Florence Ballard's replacement, Cindy Birdsong, had left by this point. And Cindy Birdsong's replacement was Linda Lawrence. Now, Linda Lawrence had previously been a backing singer for Stevie Wonder. So, 1973, The Supremes were no longer having hits. So she approached Stevie to ask that he write them a song, just to update their sound. And that's what he did with this. Now, obviously it's a Supreme single, so it's not exactly obscure, but I do think it's a bit of a hidden gem. I mean, obviously the Supremes have got much bigger tunes than this, but I think it's one that's often overlooked. It's got a real charm to it, a real funk to it. And this last week, this has been my go-to song. So see what you think. So cool. Right, okay. So next up, this is Minnie Riperton's album, Perfect Angel. So her debut album came out in 1970 and was produced by Charles Stepney. This is the follow-up. This came out in 1974. So when the record company asked Minnie Riperton who she'd like to produce the album, she said Stevie Wonder. Now, Stevie Wonder at this point was right in the midst of that perfect run of albums that he made for Motown, sort of between 1970 and 1976. So he was pretty busy. He had his hands full, but he did say he'd produce this record, but he didn't want Motown to know, and mainly because this album was going to be competing directly with his album Phil Furness's First Finale, which I think came out sort of a month or two either side of this record. So they're in direct competition. But he did produce this album. Well, he co-produced it with Richard Rudolph. But yeah, he wrote a couple of songs. He wrote the track Take a Little Trip, but also wrote the title track Perfect Angel, which I think is a lovely track. Great vocal from Minnie Riperton, so I'll do a needle drop on that one. Okay, and finally, this is obviously an obvious choice, but still, this is Rufus and Chaka Khan and the tune Tell Me Something Good. So this is their second album, Rags to Rufus. So basically the story goes, I heard an interview with Chaka Khan recently where she explained that she approached Stevie Wonder for a song, and he duly, you know, came up with the goods and offered this song to them, and she turned it down. She basically, it wasn't good enough. So, I mean, this was, I say, 1974, again, you know, right in the thick of his golden period with those, say, those wonderful albums that he recorded for Motown at that point. And she turned this tune down. Now, I don't know how many people would turn down a Stevie Wonder song at that point, but there you go. And he came back with a different song, Tell Me Something Good. Now, Tell Me Something Good, an obvious hit single. It was a massive tune in the US. I don't know whether it was released in the UK as a single, but it was certainly a top five hit in the US. And I mean, I can't think of anybody else at that sort of point who could give away such an obvious hit single, but Stevie did. It's a stone cold classic, and I'll do another drop on that as well. So cheers.
I got something that'll show love. Such magic in being with you, 'cause it's true.